Welcome to Unacademy Ascend YouTube channel. This is K. Umamesh Rao. Unacademy ESC and GATE presents Unacademy GATE Champs. Amazing scholarships. Top 100 learners will be selected for a special champs program. Monitoring by the elite panel of educators. Special practice classes. Additional problem solving sessions on difficult topics. Fortnightly interaction with face educators. Unacademy presents raise a hand option. It is another feature. Talk with your favorite educators in the live class and clear your doubts. Another feature by Unacademy, ask a doubt by Unacademy. Go to the doubts and solutions feature on your home screen. Ask a doubt, upload your doubt image. Select the subject that the question falls under. You will get the solution within 24 hours. Unacademy presents 1:1 live mentorship platform. Book a dedicated 1:1 sessions with your mentor on iconic subscription. Discuss your doubts, clarify your concepts, live mentoring sessions for exam strategy. Special class features, interactive live classes, polls for the learners, respond to the polls for a better understanding of the topic, never miss a class, get notified for upcoming classes, and recommendations by best educators just for you. Lecture notes, download the lecture notes, get access to the recorded sessions of live classes. Watch our classes live or recorded anytime from any of your devices, anytime, anywhere. Unacademy is announcing new batches in Mechanical Engineering, Civil Engineering for GATE 2022 and GATE 2023, ESC 2022 and ESC 2023. Last push to your GATE and ESC 2022 preparation. With all new 4-month subscription. Top educator batches to help you with the last minute preparation. Rank improved batches. 15 plus full length mock tests for GATE and ESC. Topic wise, subject wise tests. 10,000 plus questions for practice along with previous 10 year GATE official papers. Clear all your doubts with new Ask a Doubt or raise a hand feature. Subscribe 4 months of Unacademy for GATE and ESC and get extra 1 month subscription free. Price hike is coming soon. Use code KUR75LIVE to get 10% off. Welcome to the Master Calculus in 10 days practice session. Limit extends to infinite e power 1 by 5x minus 1 of 5x plus x by 5 into sine 1 by x. To evaluate this limit extends to infinite e power 1 by 5x minus 1 into 5x plus limit extends to infinite e power 1 by 5x minus 1 into x by 5 sine 1 by x. Limit extends to infinite is nothing but 1 by x tends to 0. 1 by 5x minus 1 by 1 by 5x. Limit extends to infinite is nothing but 1 by x tends to 0. e power 1 by 5x minus 1 sine 1 by x by 1 by x. When 1 by x is tending to 0, e power 1 by 5x minus 1 by 1 by 5x is 1. Because limit t tends to 0, e power t minus 1 by t 1 plus. When 1 by x is tending to 0, e power 1 by x tends to e power 0, that is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 into 1 by 5 into 1. 0 into 1 by 5 into 1. That is 1 plus 0, that is 1. So final answer is 1. The value of the limit is 1. Next problem. The values of a and b for which the function is continuous everywhere. The values of a and b for which the function is continuous everywhere. F of x is 2x plus 1 when x less than or equal to 1. Ax square plus b 1 less than x less than 3. 5x plus 2a when x greater than or equal to 3. Given that the function is continuous everywhere. If the function is continuous everywhere, the function is continuous at x equal to 1 as well as at x equal to 3. Therefore, left hand limit equal to right hand limit equal to functional value at 1. Left hand limit equal to right hand limit equal to functional value at 3. When x is tending to 1, 2 plus 1, 3. When x is tending to 1, a plus b, called it 1. When x is tending to 3, left hand limit, when x is tending to 3, 9a plus b. When x is tending to 3, 15 plus 2a. 7a plus b equal to 15. 7a plus b equal to 15. Called it equation 2. From 1 and 2. Seven a plus b is 15. A plus b is 3. Subtract 7a minus a. 6a equal to 12. A is 2. Substituting a equal to 2 here, b is equal to 1. Therefore, final answer is a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1. A is 2 and b is 1. Next one. The values of a and b such that limit extends to 0. A sin square x plus b log cos x by x power 4 equal to 1 by 2. Here, limit extends to 0. A sin square x plus b B log cos x by x power 4 equal to 1 by 2. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 0, 0 by 0 form. Whenever limit is 0 by 0 form, you have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of x power 4 is 4x cube. Differentiation of a sin square x is a into 2 sin x into cos x. B into 1 by cos x into minus sin x equal to 1 by 2. That is, limit x tends to 0. Denominator is 4x cube. Numerator is a into sin 2x minus b tan x equal to 1 by 2. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0. Whenever numerator is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 0, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of 4x cube is 12x square. Differentiation of a sin 2x is a into 2 cos 2x minus b into secant square x equal to 1 by 2. When x is tending to 0, numerator is 2a minus b. 2a minus b by 0. 2a minus b by 0 equal to 1 by 2, which is possible only when 2a minus b equal to 0. This is called equation 1. When x is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 2a minus b. If 2a minus b is 0, then 0 by 0 form will come. If 0 by 0 form comes after finite number of steps, you will get a finite value. That is 1 by 2. Given that the limit is 1 by 2, that is a finite value. So, 2a minus b by 0 equal to finite is possible only when 2a minus b is 0. That's why it is again 0 by 0 form. That's why we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Since 2a minus b equal to 0, therefore we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of denominator is 24x. Differentiation of numerator is minus 4a sin 2x. Minus b into 2 secant x into secant x tan x equal to 1 by 2. Now, limit x tends to 0. Denominator is 24x. Numerator is minus 4a sin 2x minus 2b secant square x into tan x equal to 1 by 2. It is in the form of 0 by 0. Whenever limit is 0 by 0 form, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of denominator is 24. Differentiation of numerator is minus 8a cos 2x minus 2b of secant square x. Differentiation of tan x is secant square x plus tan x into. Differentiation of secant square x is 2 secant x into secant x tan x. The secant x tan x can be written as here secant square x, here tan square x equal to 1 by 2. When x is tending to 0, denominator is 24, numerator is minus 8a minus 2b equal to 1 by 2. That implies minus 4a minus b minus 4a minus b by 12 equal to 1 by 2. That is minus 4a minus b equal to 6. Called it equation 2. 2a minus b equal to 0. That is equation 1. 2a minus b equal to 0 is equation 1. Subtract. Minus. Plus. Minus. Minus 6a equal to 6. So, a equal to minus 1. B equal to 2a. That's why b equal to minus 2. A is minus 1 and b is minus 2. So, the correct answer is a is minus 1, b is minus 2. Next problem. Limit x tends to 0. X of e power x minus 1 plus 2 into cos x minus 1 by x of 1 minus cos x. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0, 0 by 0 form. Whenever limit is 0 by 0 form, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of numerator is x into differentiation of e power x minus 1 is e power x. E power x minus 1 into differentiation of x is 1 plus 2 into differentiation of cos x is minus sin x by differentiation of x into 1 minus cos x. Differentiation of 1 minus cos x is sin x. 1 minus cos x into differentiation of x is 1. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0, 0 by 0 form. Whenever limit is 0 by 0 form, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of numerator, x e power x plus e power x. Differentiation of e power x minus 1, e power x. Differentiation of minus 2 sin x, minus 2 cos x by differentiation of x sin x, sin x into differentiation of x is 1, x into cos x plus differentiation of 1 minus cos x is sin x. Now, when x is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 0, numerator is also tending to 0, 0 by 0 form. Whenever limit is 0 by 0 form, we have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of sin x is cos x. Differentiation of x cos x is cos x into differentiation of x is 1, x into minus sin x plus differentiation of sin x is cos x. Differentiation of x into e power x is x into e power x plus e power x. Differentiation of e power x is e power x. Differentiation of e power x is e power x. Differentiation of minus 2 cos x is plus 2 sin x. When x is tending to 0, numerator is 0 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0 by 1 plus 1 plus 0 plus 1. That is 3 by 3. That is 1. Finally, the value of limit is 1. let L is limit x tends to pi by 2 sine square 2x by x minus pi by 2 whole square sine square 2x plus sine square 2x by x minus pi by 2 whole square limit x tends to pi by 2 sine square 2x by x minus pi by 2 whole square. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0. 0 by 0 form. By applying L'Hospital rule, limit x tends to pi by 2. Differentiation of numerator is 2 sine 2x. Differentiation of sine 2x is 2 cos 2x by 2 into x minus pi by 2. Differentiation of x minus pi by 2 is 1. These two cancel. When x is tending to pi by 2, two sine 2x cos 2x is sine 4x by x minus pi by 2. When x is tending to pi by 2, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0. 0 by 0 form. Limit x tends to pi by 2. Differentiation of denominator is 1. Differentiation of numerator is 4 cos 4x. When x is tending to pi by 2, when x is tending to pi by 2, 4 cos 4 into pi by 2 is 2 pi. That is 4 into 1. Final answer is 4. The value of limit is 4. Next problem. Limit. The function f of x is sin x by x, x not equal to 0, which is 1 when x equal to 0. Then the function f is not continuous at x equal to 0. The function is continuous at x equal to 0 but not differentiable at x equal to 0. The function f is differentiable at x equal to 0, f dash 0 is 0. The function is differentiable at x equal to 0, f dash 0 is 1. Which one is correct? Observe, we have to examine f dash 0. Observe, f dash of 0 is nothing but limit x tends to 0, f of x minus f of 0 by x minus 0. Limit x tends to 0. F of x is sin x by x minus f of 0 is 1 by x minus 0 is x. Limit x tends to 0. Sin x minus x by x into x, x square. Sin x minus x by x square. When x is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 0, numerator is also tending to 0. 0 by 0 form. Whenever limit is in 0 by 0 form, you have to apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of sin x minus x. Differentiation of sin x is cos x. Differentiation of x is 1. Differentiation of x square is 2x. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is also tending to 0. 0 by 0 form. Apply L'Hospital rule. Limit x tends to 0. Differentiation of 2x is 2. Differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. When x is tending to 0, numerator is tending to 0, denominator is tending to 2. 0 by 2 is 0. So final answer is 0. Therefore, we can conclude that f of x is differentiable at x equal to 0 and f dash of 0 is 0. The function is differentiable at x equal to 0 and f dash of 0 is 0. Therefore, third option is correct. Next problem. What should be the value of lambda such that the function defined below is continuous at x equal to pi by 2? What should be the value of lambda such that the function below is continuous at x equal to pi by 2? Generally, a function f of x is said to be continuous at pi by 2. Limit extends to pi by 2, f of x equal to f of pi by 2. That is, limit extends to pi by 2. F of x is lambda cos x by pi by 2 minus x. Functional value at pi by 2 is 1. When x is tending to pi by 2, denominator is tending to 0, numerator is also tending to 0. That is, limit extends to pi by 2. Differentiation of numerator is lambda into minus sin x. Differentiation of denominator is minus 1 equal to 1. Because they have provided that functional value at pi by 2 is 1. Now, minus minus cancel. Limit extends to pi by 2. Lambda sin x equal to 1. When x is tending to pi by 2, lambda sin pi by 2 equal to 1. Sin pi by 2 value is 1. Therefore, lambda is equal to 1. The value of lambda is 1. Understood? Next problem. Which one of the following function is continuous at x equal to 3? Continuous at x equal to 3. Observe. At x equal to 3, functional value is 2. When x is tending to 3, 3 minus 1, that is also 2. At x equal to 3, it is 2. At x greater than 3, it is 2. When x less than 3, 3 plus 3, 6 by 3 is 2. So, functional value at x equal to 3 is 2. Functional value at x equal to 3 is 2. X greater than 3 is 2. X less than 3 is 2. So, left hand limit is 2. Right hand limit is 2. And the functional value is 2. Therefore, the first option is continuous at x equal to 3. The function is continuous at x equal to 3 in the case of first option. Next one. Limit. The function f of x is x power a sine 1 by x, x not equal to 0, which is 0 when x equal to 0. Is differentiable at x equal to 0 for all values of a in the interval. Now, f dash of 0 is limit extends to 0. F of x minus f of 0 by x minus 0. Limit extends to 0. Denominator is x, numerator. F of x is x power a sine 1 by x minus f of 0 is 0. Now, limit x tends to 0, x power a minus 1 sin 1 by x. Suppose if a minus 1 is less than 0, suppose a is 0, then sin 1 by x, sin 1 by x, okay na? So suppose if a equal to 1, then sin 1 by x limit extends to 0. Limit is oscillatory, so function is not differentiable. Suppose a minus 1 greater than 0. If a minus 1 is greater than 0, then if a minus 1 is greater than 0, then f dash 0 exists. The function is differentiable. So a greater than 1. That's why a belongs to the interval 1 to infinite. Open interval 1 to infinite. So correct answer is third option. If a value is in between 1 to infinite, the function is differentiable at x equal to 0. Next problem. F of x is e power x when x less than 1. Log x plus ax square plus bx when x greater than or equal to 1. Now f dash x is differentiation of e power x is e power x. Differentiation of log x is 1 by x, 2ax plus b. Observe here, when x is tending to 1, left hand limit is e, right hand limit is 0 plus a plus b. The function is continuous, a plus b should be equal to e. Called it equation 1. When x is tending to 1 from left, left hand derivative is e, right hand derivative is 1 plus 2a plus b. Left hand derivative equal to right hand derivative. 2a plus b equal to e minus 1. Called it equation 2. A plus b is e, 2a plus b is e minus 1. From 1 and 2, a plus b is e, 2a plus b is e minus 1, minus, minus, minus. A minus 2a, minus a, e minus e plus 1. Minus a equal to 1, a equal to minus 1, the value of a is minus 1. Since a plus b equal to e, therefore b equal to e plus 1. So the conclusion is, when a is equal to minus 1 and b equal to e plus 1, the function is continuous as well as differentiable. So the conclusion is, the function is differentiable at x equal to 1 for unique values of a and b, for a is minus 1 and b is e plus 1. That is the correct answer. Next problem. Consider the function f of x equal to mod x whole cube, where x is real. Then the function f of x is continuous at x equal to 0 is continuous but not differentiable, once differentiable but not twice, twice differentiable but not thrice, thrice differentiable. F of x equal to mod x cube. Minus x cube when x less than 0, x cube when x greater than or equal to 0. Now, left hand limit 0, right hand limit 0, functional value at 0 is 0. Therefore, f of x is continuous at x equal to 0. Now, f dash x is minus 3x square when x less than 0, plus 3x square when x greater than or equal to 0. Left hand derivative is 0. Right hand derivative is 0. Left hand derivative equal to right hand derivative. Therefore, f of x is derivable at x equal to 0. That means first derivative exists. F dash 0 exists finitely. Since first derivative exists, it is differentiable first time. Now, f double dash x is differentiation of minus 3x square is minus 6x when x less than 0, plus 6x when x greater than or equal to 0. Left hand derivative is 0. Right hand derivative is 0. Left hand derivative equal to right hand derivative. Therefore, we can conclude that f dash x is derivable at x equal to 0 because f double dash 0 exists finitely. Since second derivative exists, therefore, first derivative is differentiable. Next, f triple dash x. Differentiation of minus 6x is minus 6 when x less than 0. This is plus 6 when x greater than or equal to 0. So, left hand derivative is minus 6. Right hand derivative is plus 6. Left hand derivative not equal to right hand derivative. F triple dash 0 does not exist. Therefore, the conclusion is first derivative exists, second derivative exists, third derivative does not exist. So, it is twice differentiable but not thrice. It is twice differentiable but not thrice. Understood? Next problem. The function f of x equal to mod x plus 1 in the interval minus 2 comma 0 is mod x plus 1 See, the function is continuous for all values of x, but it is not differentiable at x equal to minus 1. So, correct answer is, it is continuous for all values of x, but it is not different, but not differentiable at all points. Where it is not differentiable? At minus 1, it is not differentiable. Continuous on the interval, but not differentiable at all points. At minus 1, it is not differentiable because it is sharp curve. Understood? Next problem. Y is equal to mod x for x less than 0, y equal to x for x greater than 0. Now, this is graph of y. What about graph of dy by dx? Observe here. Dy by dx is nothing but 1 here. Dy by dx is minus 1 here. If you draw graph of dy by dx, dy by dx is 1 when x greater than 0. Dy by dx is 1 when x greater than 0. Dy by dx is minus 1 when x less than 0. This is graph of dy by dx. Left side of 0, it is minus 1. Right side of 0, it is 1. So, what is conclusion? The graph is discontinuous at 0. Dy by dx is discontinuous at 0 is the correct option. Dy by dx is discontinuous at x equal to 0 is the correct option. From the graph, you can understand. Understood? Thank you.